Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the series about downloading, uploading, taking, saving UI images in Swift 5, and of course with the little help of Firebase. Now, in today's video, we are finally going to upload our UI image into Firebase's storage, and let's get to work. Okay, in the previous episode, we have been taking care of setting up everything in the Firebase database we have created, our app, and we have enabled database and storage. Now it is time to type in some code. So go ahead and open up our root view controller. And again, if you already are not familiar with this, go ahead and take a look at the other episodes where I build out this app as I go with the series. Okay, now, upload photo, that is what we are going to start here. And what we want to do first here is basically start the activity indicator. So activity indicator start animating, that is our first thing. Okay, now what do we want to do? Well, we want to upload our image into Firebase storage. Now on Firebase storage, you are not going to upload the UI image. You are going to upload some data. So what we need to do is convert our UI image into data. So for that, first of all, we need to grab our image from our image view. And that is again an optional. So we are going to use guard let image equals image view image. So now let's create our data. Let data equals to, and I believe around Swift 4.2 or maybe earlier, there was something called like image, and there we go, a dot, and JPEG representation, JPEG data rather, yet with a compression quality. If you want to use PNG data, that is okay, but JPEG data has a compression quality, and I will use 1.0 here, but you could make it like 0.5 or something like that. Okay, and now that we do have our data, we just need to write our else there, and for the else, I want to show an alert, so I will go ahead and present alert with the title error, and well, something went wrong or something like that, because yeah, it's not really important. Most of the time this will never happen, so I will just write in here something went wrong. Okay, just so the user knows that we are out. And finally, let's hit return here. So what we do have now is our data. Okay, let me hit return here, so it will be real nice. Now, next up, we want to have our, let's so call it our data's place, a name. So we want to have UUID string. So let image name equals UUID dot UUID string. So that is a random string that we can use, so it will be unique. Next up, we need an image reference. So let's create that right now. So let image reference. So make sure before we start typing in here that Firebase storage is imported, and of course import Firebase store too, because in just a moment we will save all of this data into Firestore. So image reference equals storage dot storage, and just add a dot there and type in a reference. And what you want to do here is add some paths. So type in child, and the path for that is my keys. This will be a string, of course, but I have created some keys, and it will be an images folder. Okay, so that is how we use our images folder. And again, we want to add in here child and our image name. Okay, that is where we will add our data. Let me just add in here some new lines so we can see this structure better. Now it is time to put our data onto storage. So let's do that right now. So grab our image reference, add a dot, and start typing in put data. And as you can see, there are quite a lot of these, but I will use the one that has a completion handler. So this is that. And upload data is data. The metadata will be nil. And let's add in here a completion handler. Let's just hit return. And the storage metadata, metadata, there we go. And an error. So both of these are optional. So what we want to do is handle the error. So if let error equals error, then we want to bail out. And I'm just going to use, well, I'm just going to type that out. So present alert with the title error, and the message is error.localized description. And after that, we want to return, so we don't want to do anything else. Okay, now that we know that we do not have an error, we want to basically get the URL of that image, because we are basically storing that in storage. Before we do that, let's fix this. We need to add in self there. So now we want to grab our image reference and just type in download URL. There we go, with the completion. And in the completion, we get an optional URL and an optional error. Okay, first off, as usual, we take care of the error. I'm just going to copy and paste that in there. And now we need to take care of our URL. So what we do here is guard let unwrap it URL equals URL else we, if we don't have that, then something wrong went, and something went wrong is the one that we want to present in our UI alert controller. There we go. That should be great. Let's add in here a self, because we are in the completion, and now we do have our URL. Now we do have our URL. Now we need to finally fetch it. And for that, we are going to use Kingfisher, and make sure that you have imported in the pod file and that you do have it imported at the beginning of this file. So with Kingfisher, it is very easy to import it. All you need to do is type in Kingfisher manager. Oh, I almost forgot, before we handle Kingfisher, yeah, and that is downloading. I was a little bit confused. We don't download our URL. We want to save this URL into Firebase's Firestore. So let's do that now. First of all, what we need is to create a data reference to our Firestore database. So let data reference, and that is firestore.firestore. And if you type in here, you will see that is something called collection. And the collection path will use mykeys.imagesCollection. Again, this is a string that we can use. And just type in here document. Now, this will create a document ID for our data reference. So we want to fetch this document later on in the next episode. So we will fetch it with a query that basically searches for our UID, our document UID. So we do want to add this document ID into our document that we are going to save. So let's create our data now. So let data equals, and first of all, let's add in here our UID. So my keys dot, and let's select UID, and that is the document ID. So let document ID, let's call it UID equals, and that is a data reference dot document ID. Okay, and now I can simply just add that in there. Okay, next up we want to add, and let me just add in here a new line. Next up we want to basically save the URL. So my key is dot URL or image URL rather. That is our URL. Or yeah, this is something that I get into very often. As you can see, this is basically a URL, but in the databases, you cannot add just a string. You cannot add URLs. So what we need to do now is in here that we do have our URL, we need to guard let unwrap our URL string. So let URL string equals URL dot absolute string. Okay, let's see. And now we can use this URL string here. Okay, good point. And this is a heterogeneous, and I believe, yeah, it must be conditional, so we don't need to put it in the guard let statement. So let's clear that out. And yeah, maybe add it right here. Okay, let's wait for the completions, and yeah, there we go. And now we can finally save all of this data to the data reference. So data reference, let me just make this a little bit more up, and just type in set data and choose the one with the completion handler. And the document data is basically the data. And let's take care of our completion handler error. And I will just copy and paste the error here. There we go. And if this succeeds, I believe we are ready. So what do we need to do here? Well, we need to create an alert. I'll just copy and paste that in there, that says this was success. And let's just add a message. Oh, one last thing that we will add here, that is to save this UID in the user defaults, so we can use it when we are trying to download the image. So let's call user defaults dot standard and set value of any, and the value will be our document UID, and for the string, for the my key will be my keys, and there we go, image, or rather yet UID. Let's use this UID. Finally, we want to clear out the image views image, because in the next video we are going to download that image. So self.imageView.image equals UI image. And I believe we are ready to test this out. Let's just plug in our iPhone here and let's see if we do get everything right. Okay, let me just show you the QuickTime player. We are connected, there we go. Okay, let's build and run on our phone and let's see what happens. Let me unlock this. There we go, we have our last tutorials custom album. So let's take our photo, and there we go. Here is my keyboard. Let's use this photo. And now let's tap on upload, and hopefully everything will work as expected. So upload. Oh, sorry about that. I haven't connected the action there. Oh, rather yet, it did. Successfully saved image to database. I didn't notice the activity indicator, but yeah, that should be it. And we have completed the action by just simply removing that image from the image view. Maybe the activity indicator was grayish and that is why I didn't see that coming. Okay, let's double check on the browser if we do have inside our storage the new image. So let's see images folder, great. And here is our image and I believe this is a test image, so that is okay. And now let's go to our database and see if we do have our images collection. Yeah, I most probably hit that twice. Okay, and that wasn't a test image, it's the same image. Yeah, you want to make sure that this doesn't happen. Okay, and there we go. We have our image URL and our UID. Now that we have uploaded our image, in the next video, we are going to download it. So, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. And I will see you in the next one.